So welcome back to Intelligent Bishop, and today we are going to see game of the day in Legends of Chess tournament. Let me talk about the tournament first. This tournament include 8 players who are legend in chess, and the games are going to be very very strong in this tournament. So let's see one of the strongest game of day one, where Magnus Carlsen, the world champion, was able to defeat Anish Giri, one of the strongest player in chess. So let's look at the game. So white plays d4, white is Magnus Carlsen and black is Anish Giri. d4, knight f6, c4, pawn to e6. So this is Nimzo Indian. This opening is known as Nimzo Indian. Knight f3, both are trying to develop the pieces. d5, taking control over the center. Then knight to c3, nothing much to discuss in the opening because it's pretty decent. Bishop b4, so he's pinning the knight and stopping white from playing e4. So bishop g5, similarly white is also pinning black's knight. h6, immediately kicking the bishop back. Bishop to d2, bishop goes behind. Now castle. Now this is very important phase of the game, because as you can see, black has pretty well developed and pretty decent position. Similarly white is also having few pieces developed, but his king is still in the center. So white has two options over here: either to play queen to c2 and castle on queen side, or he can start the attack immediately, which Carlsen chooses. So Magnus Carlsen, with his playing style, plays g4, starts immediate attack. He sees that opponent has committed this move at h6 and it has already weakened the castle. Whenever the pawn is on h6, you can play moves like g4 and h4. So he immediately starts with g4. This is a novelty. So bishop into c3, bishop into c3, knight to e4. So black is bringing his knight to center, and yes, he's trying to get some compensation and he's trying to defend this attack. Queen c2, developing move, and also he's tempting towards castling to queen side. So Magnus Carlsen playing pretty strong game. c5. Now Anish Giri is challenging in the center. As you can see that the attack on the side or attack on the wing must be answered by attack in the center. So Anish Giri is trying to follow this principle, and which is pretty well. So pawn into c5. Now let's see. If knight takes c5, then white will strongly attack with g5, and as you can see, the bishop is open, queen is open, rook will come to the open file, and black will soon get checkmated because it's too much attack and white is attacking with all of his pieces, but black is not having any piece for his defense. So black has to maintain the knight on center. So after pawn takes pawn, black plays b6. So he's trying to bring his bishop maybe to b7 or to a6. So g5. Now white has started the attack. So basically black should play h5 instead of taking that pawn. h5 will not give as much attack as it gives after h into g5. So ideally black should not capture this pawn, but Anish Giri takes h into g5. He accepts the challenge given by Magnus Carlsen. So h4, the world champion, starts in his way. Now if he takes If he takes h4, he will simply lose, because you will just open the rook file and there is tremendous attack on the king. So after g4, now knight g5. Magnus Carlsen is attacking ruthlessly. Now if knight into g5, pawn into g5, and as you can see, this mate is unavoidable on h7. And if Anish Giri wants to defend it, he'll play g6, but still there is one checkmate with rook h8, as you can see. So Magnus Carlsen will win if Anish Giri takes on g5. So he plays f5, trying to defend this knight on e4, which is very very strong and holding the entire position. Bishop to g2, b into c5, pretty natural moves. Now castle queenside. Now at this point, I would like to tell you all that white is completely better in this position, as I have made some arrows showing that how white pieces are active and how black pieces are inactive. If you look at this bishop on c3, it is eyeing towards the king side. The knight, which is placed on g5, is controlling the escape squares of king. Then the queen and bishop are attacking the knight, and as soon as the knight moves, they'll fire on both the sides of the board. The rooks are on the open and half open files respectively, firing on black, whereas the black pieces, bishop on c8, knight on b8 and rook on a8, are just sleeping. The king is weak, there are no defenders on king, whereas white king is safer. So Magnus Carlsen is completely dominating on the board. So Anish Giri, who was hoping for knight on e4 to defend, has given up and he has decided to take on g5. So knight into g5, h into g5, queen into g5. White has already successful in opening the rook file, and now king just moves to safety after queen into g5 check. And as you can see, Magnus Carlsen's bishop are firing on both sides of the board. So now Anish Giri tries to defend by improving his position and developing some pieces. So knight d7, pawn takes pawn. Now if black captures, then bishop into d5, just check, and rook on a8 will die. As you can see, if pawn takes pawn, then bishop takes, and this will attack the king as well as the rook, so he cannot capture. So knight to b6, pawn into pawn, bishop into pawn, bishop takes rook. As I have said earlier, Magnus Carlsen is material wise up and he's trying to win this game. So rook into a8, Anish Giri desperately takes the rook, bishop on a8. Queen d2, Carlsen immediately offers queen exchange after he's up in the material, as the basic principle says that you should exchange more pieces when you are up in the material. So queen g6, queen to d6, f4 was a check, so king moves to a1, king to the safety. Anish Giri plays rook to f8, trying to bring his rook. Now let me tell you that there is a checkmate in 3. Rook h8 check, king into h8, and when king moves to h7, rook h1 check, queen h6 and queen into g7. Black can't take the queen because it's in pin. This is a checkmate, and you can't imagine that the world champion missed it. He played queen to e5. Magnus Carlsen missed mate in 3. Unbelievable. So g3. Now Anish is trying to create some counter instead of defending. So takes a knight to c4. Queen to h5. Queen into queen. Rook into queen. As I have said earlier, that Magnus will try to just exchange the pieces as he's up in the material. Knight to e3, attacking the rook on d1. Rook moves to g1. Rook moves to an active file. Bishop f5. So the last counter attack try by Anish Giri. So his plan is to play knight to c2, check king b1 and knight d4, check again and take on e2. So black white, that is Magnus Carlsen, plays b3 and makes an escaping square for his king on b2. So pawn takes pawn, rook takes bishop to g4. Anish Giri is fighting really well, I can say that. So rook into pawn, rook f1 check, king moves, king comes out, and knight d1 check, king a3. So now, after knight into c3, white is having two options, either to take the knight or to take the bishop. Now Magnus Carlsen plays rook takes g4, and Anish Giri resigns because Magnus Carlsen is winning completely, as I will show you some variations. If knight into e4, then rook e4 wins. If knight b1, then king to b2 wins. If knight comes to d1, then rook c8 check wins, or e4 wins, because the pawn is just unstoppable. Moreover, black plays anything else, then white will simply take this knight on c3, as it is under attack. So where the knight will go? The knight is actually trapped. Knight cannot go anywhere. If knight into e4, then knight into e2, then rook e4 wins. So this was a very, very superb game by world champion Magnus Carlsen, and the move g4, which was novelty, has, I think so, made the day for Magnus Carlsen. So thanks for watching, and I hope you enjoyed the analysis. You understood well the concepts and how the world champion plays with another strong player. So thanks for watching this video, and if you like the content, subscribe to our channel, because I am going to put all the analysis of top games.